this is my documentary of Jonhnny Jones paddling with purpose. It's been the sort of the campaign for this whole project that I'm doing. There's a 10K kayaking race with the Triangle Paddlers Association, or Triangle Paddlers Club, whatever they wanna, I guess, designate themselves as. And I mean, it's been fun, a lot of training, and it's for a good cause, raising money for the Orange County Rape Crisis Center, which I am a board member. And so you may ask, why would a black man go kayak? I ask myself that question a lot of times too, but it actually started with a person that works in the building that I work in. Her husband is the organizer of the race. You'll probably meet her, Jennifer Hastings. We used to go on these walks with Ron, and she brought up the idea of me kayaking. And you know, a couple of times I was like, no, that's crazy. Why would I go kayaking? And so I just blew her off, like, no, whatever. And so she kept asking. At the same time, I sort of had the idea of, you know, how can I have more of an impact with the Rape Crisis Center? You know, I've been a board member, I guess maybe for about 8 months at that point. And, you know, I would go to the board meetings and do small things here and there, but I was still trying to figure out a way to have, I guess, a significant impact on, you know, the different things that they're trying to do there. So it sort of clicked, like, hey, do the kayaking race, something that no one would probably ever expect you to do, and at the same time, do it as a fundraiser for the Rape Crisis Center. So that is how I end up here with this boat. Her name's Tequila, by the way. I love my boat. And, you know, paddling. The race is Sunday, July 23rd, early, 9:30 a.m. There's two, I guess, legs of it, but I'm just doing the 10K, you know. There's a 20K, but you have to be like a U.S. Olympic level type guy, and you can look at me and see that I'm not nowhere near Olympic shape. But, I mean, it should be fun, tiring, you know, all that good stuff, but it's for a good cause. It's been a lot of work raising the money for the race, but as of today, I actually did reach the financial goal, so that's been a great thing for me. I had a lot of people step up and, you know, show their support for the race, so I'm excited about that, and, you know, I guess ready to get it over with.
We're very grateful that Jonhnny is doing this kayaking trip on behalf of the Orange County Rape Crisis Center. For more than 30 years, the Rape Crisis Center has worked within Orange County to support those whose lives have been affected by sexual violence. We focus a lot on education. For example, we're in all the public schools within Orange County, in both the Chapel Hill Carborough City School System and the Orange County School System. Going into classrooms, just about every kindergarten through fifth grade classroom, with messages of safety, helping kids understand that their body belongs to them, that it's okay to tell someone if they're touched in an uncomfortable way. You know, as folks might imagine, to offer 24-hour services and to reach more than 10,000 people a year through just about all the classrooms in the county, costs money, and so we rely a lot on the support of this community and the generosity of people in the community to help us meet our budget. So projects like this wonderful kayaking race that Jonhnny Jones is doing as one of our board of directors members helps keep us on the ground. It allows us to provide those 24-hour services.
Okay, so you're probably wondering about the beard. The beard has just been sort of my motivation beard to kind of remind me every morning when I get up of the mission that I'm on. And the funny thing is when I first started growing the beard, I was like, oh, well, yeah, you know, my beard's never grow, so it probably wouldn't get thicker than 1/20th of an inch. But it's sort of gotten out of control, so I can't wait to cut the doggone thing off. But like I say, it has been, you know, helpful to keep you motivated on those days where, like on the weekends, where you get up and you're just like, okay, I just want to do nothing all day and lay around. You know, as soon as you get up, you brush your teeth, you see that beard, and it kind of keeps you motivated to go and paddle away. And I guess as a friend of mine, Casey Saucy, says, just keep paddling, just keep paddling. So, you know, that's been helpful and inspiring at the same time. So, it's funny. So, this is the beautiful Lake Crabtree, and the race is actually gonna take place beginning sort of down here. There's a beach area past this pier, and so we're gonna come from down there. I guess that's maybe a third of a mile there, and we're gonna come from paddling from over there to there. Two buoys over there, small orange buoys over in that area. We're gonna go all the way there, and then from there, you can't see it, but past this tree is two laps of those, and each lap is about 3 miles. So I think I probably just said it's a third of a mile, so get my math right, you know. Radio, TV, and film major. We focus on math, but six. So it's actually maybe about a half a mile from each buoy. Yeah, so that makes sense. No. You know, I would have been up there, you know, with the heavyweights, but, you know, I had some tendonitis kicking, you know, trying to do too many things, play basketball, and, you know, kayak, and, you know, just be the super dude that I am, but, you know, it'd be fun. I think about kayaking and just being out here in the lake. It's become sort of like therapy for me. You know, I haven't had a chance to get out here as much as I would like to, but the times that I do, yeah, it's hard. It feels like my arms are about to fall off, but at the same time, you know, once you just zone out, you get in that spot in your head. So relaxing, you know. There's a couple spots down here I go, you just see all kind of big birds, you see the turtles just pop up, and you just sort of realize that you're out of your element, and you're in their element, you know. So it's like you have to respect their land, respect what they're doing, but that's sort of getting sidetracked from the point of this documentary. I mean, I've actually grown to enjoy the racing or the kayaking. I haven't done a race yet, but, you know, it's cool. It's cool. You know, so you just have to be one with the water. And the funny thing about it, too, is I don't know how to swim. You know, brothers in water go together. Brothers in big bodies of water go together like crooks and cops, man. Like, we just don't do water, but... You know, you just have to step out of your zone and, you know, just do it. You know, you only live one life, so why not do something that you never imagined yourself doing? So, I mean, that's fun. You know, like I say, you know, the whole thing about it is, you know, me doing something that, I guess for me, it's a challenge. But, you know, the bigger point is that so many people were able to see it as a challenge and then support me in doing this and, you know, donate money. Yeah, some people, you know, one friend, you know, before all of this, we weren't even all that great friends, just someone I knew from school, and like, he just off the break, like, bam, here's 100. I'm like, man, but that just shows the genuine spirit within people to give what they have, you know, their hard-earned money to support something like this, man. Someone like me, you know. So I mean, that motivates me when I'm out here, and I'll try to do the race on my own. You know, you get to that last leg, and you just want to quit. You're thinking, there's no way I could do this race. I mean, you think about people who stepped up and supported what you're doing already. You think about the cause, you know, just supporting the Orange County Rape Crisis Center, and more so just champion that we do need more support behind other centers that help so many people that are going through different things such as sexual assault, rape victims, things like that. Just spreading the awareness of it, you know, and that's what keeps you pushing. You think about the people that had to go through something like this and, you know, I guess raising funds so the center can do more, so the center can reach more kids in the school system, or they can be there when people may call, you know, at the hospital. They're just been a victim of sexual assault, you know, just so that there can be more done to, I guess, end it one day. That's the ultimate goal. You want to end it, end sexual assault. You know, it sounds like a crazy goal, but if you don't have that goal, then what's the point of doing anything to, you know, speak out or prevent it? So it's like this is just peaceful right now. You know, the wind's blowing. I know in a few minutes I'm gonna try to get out here and do the 10K on my own, but right now this is peace for me. This is just take it all in, you know. Think about it, just take it in. Y'all feeling the Daisy Dukes?
Jonhnny is such a dreamer that when he came to me with this idea, honestly, I didn't really take him seriously. He comes to me with harebrained ideas at least once a month, so I thought that this was just another one of those. So I didn't pay him much mind, but then he started researching and searching for a boat, and then he made a commitment to the Orange County Rape Crisis Center that he would actually raise funds for their cause by doing this race. When he did that, I knew that it was a done deal because he's such a man of his word. If he gives somebody his word, then he's gonna do it. He would never quit it. So I knew that he would do it then. And I am so proud of him. Jonhnny has never kayaked in his entire life. He doesn't even know how to swim. So to do something this challenging was just amazing to me.
See you Sunday.
You know, having a rape crisis in our town is obviously a sign that it is a big issue. And you know, over the years, I've worked with clients, and I've seen that hopelessness, and I've seen that pain there as well. But one thing I've seen by having a rape crisis center is that hope. And you know, we always say that we want to provide a place of help, hope, and healing for people. And I feel like that's what the rape crisis center has done. And so I think for me, when it goes back to, you know, why is there a man at the center? It's because, you know, I'm ready to be a part of the solution. And I feel like if you're not part of the solution, then you're part of the problem. You know, it's not something that we can ignore because it does affect so many people. And, you know, if that situation had ever come up again with a friend or with somebody I don't know, then, you know, I feel like now I kind of have those kind of tools to be able to respond to that in a little bit better manner.
Well, it's race morning, Fairlake Crabtree, like, it may rain today, you never know with the weather. I mean, just, it's a lot better than being blazing hot, so that's a good thing. You know, my feelings right now, happy to be at this point. Happy that the money that we set out to raise was raised so that, you know, benefit the Orange County Rape Crisis Center and their cause. So that's a great feeling. Definitely get you motivated when you just think about what's about to take place. Nervous. I guess like maybe the last two nights really haven't been able to sleep just thinking about